The Human African Trypanosomiasis, HAT, otherwise known as the sleeping sickness, is a life-threatening disease that afflicts poor rural populations.
But the good news is that it's a very small proportion of the entire trypanosomiasis that we have in the world.
In Uganda, the disease was first reported in 1927, and for several decades, the country has been battling it. Since 1995, the government has employed several methods to end the disease, especially in the West Nile region.
Uganda has met the established criteria for the elimination of Gambezi, Human African Trypanosomiasis, as a public health problem.
After several years, the World Health Organization has finally declared Uganda free of sleeping sickness. This was during an event under the theme celebrating elimination of Gambia's sleeping sickness as a public health threat.
WHO recommends that quality care remains available for affected patients throughout the country, underlying throughout the country.
Here, health experts commended Uganda for such a huge milestone.
I would like to offer my sincere congratulations on reaching this momentous achievement.
The next phase was a large-scale control intervention, and this started in 2014 and covered 2,500 square kilometers over 5 districts of West Nile.
Lucy Faida, a survivor of sleeping sickness, narrates the ordeal she underwent while suffering from the disease. Meanwhile, Minister of Health Dr. Jane Ruth Acheng disclosed that in the past 2 years, they have not registered a single case of sleeping sickness, an indication that the disease could be no more in the country.
Eliminating Gambiense as a public health problem means that it is no longer a threat to the public. It also means that cases are no longer there, but it does not mean it cannot recur if we don't put in efforts to ensure that it does not.
Acheng further reveals that the next course of action is to ensure that all people coming into the country are screened to ensure that they do not have the disease.
It means the cross-border collaboration must continue so that working together with our colleagues on the other side of the borders from South Sudan and DRC, we ensure that no cases cross back into Uganda.